Hi, I'm Jen. Welcome. One of the most common questions I'm asked about getting into data science or data analytics is, can I be a data scientist with a blank degree, a math degree, a physics degree, a programming degree, a business degree? So today I'm going to break down for you data science degree options and exactly what degrees you can get into data science with. There are great data scientist degree and data analyst degree programs out there, but they're relatively new. So if you're already in the workforce, chances are you're not one of the people that has these degrees, unless you've graduated within the past 5 or so years. On the other hand, maybe you're a junior or senior in college and you've recently decided that you want to go into data analysis or data science, but your degree is in a different area. Do you need to start over? Do you need to go back for another degree? Probably not. So let's look at what that might mean for you. If you have a technical background of any sort, and specifically a technical degree of any sort, chances are extremely strong that that's exactly the data scientist degree that you need. It is very common for people to go into data science and data analytics with degrees in things like math, statistics, programming, computer science, because these are really the background and the foundation of the work that you're going to be doing as a data scientist. And prior to the last 5 to 10 years, there really weren't programs that you could go to specifically for a data scientist degree or a data analyst degree. Maybe you don't specifically have a math or statistics degree. Maybe you don't have an engineering degree or a programming degree. That's okay too. The biggest thing that a good degree program will have that will prepare you for a data scientist or data analyst job is something that does have some math skills, some logic skills, and hopefully some programming skills. Most of the programs that are out there, the area that tends to be the weakest is that programming skills, unless maybe you are a programmer or you have a computer science degree. A lot of people in the business and math end may or may not have any exposure to programming in their degree. That doesn't mean you can't build those skills, though, or that you need to go specifically take a course on programming. I'm a self-taught programmer, and many people are the same. There are lots of free and cheap resources that you can learn to program on your own outside of a degree environment. That doesn't mean that those programs that teach you how to program or code are bad. For some people, that's the way they learn best. They need that structured environment to learn those data analyst programming skills or those data scientist IT programming skills that you need for the job. If you do specifically go take a programming training, make sure that you're taking one that goes into depth on a specific language. There are lots of options out there as people try to cater towards this ever-growing market of data science and data analytics. And a lot of them give you a nice overview of all of the different things you might encounter. Very, very few of them give you the practical skills that you actually need to get a data scientist job, though. Most of them will touch on the highlights so you have that broad exposure, but you won't know enough that you can actually go get a job with that specific language. So if you do decide to take one of these classes or courses online or in person at your local community college or your local university, then also take time to learn one of the languages more in depth or take some specific courses that go into how to learn Python or how to learn R or how to learn SAS. Any of these programming languages that are common to data science are ones that you should focus on and pick an area to specialize. While there is a lot of room for people that are generalists, more and more companies are looking for specialists in certain languages, and there are a plethora of different options for employment in each of these languages, so you really can't make a wrong choice. If you want to know more about how you might choose between the three most common languages if you're just getting started, I'll link to another video where I talk specifically about how to pick which language that you want to learn as you're getting going into data science or data analyst jobs. If you're pursuing a data analyst job, you may or may not do very much programming. So should you even bother to learn these? I think it's helpful to know at least some programming because it gets into one of those other things I mentioned, which is logic. It forces you to think in a very structured and logical way and go from step one to two to three to four and so on, to get from something that you don't know or don't have a solution to something that you do know that possibly, probably answers some sort of business question or concern. Can you be a data scientist without any degree at all? There are some cases where you can be, and some companies will hire without it, especially if you have a lot of experience. The key is going to be showing that you can use all of these skills, that you have all of the strengths that are necessary to do this job. Some companies won't consider you without a degree, and that's something that you'll have to make a decision if it's important enough to you to go back and get that degree, or whether you'll just have to realize there are going to be less companies that may employ you. The other consideration is it may take you a lot longer to get into one of these roles. You may have to take some stepping stone roles to help prove yourself within a company or within that skill set. So this may look like starting as a data reporting analyst or some sort of data preparation role before you move up successively into higher level roles, including a data scientist position or a data analyst position. You can get these jobs without a degree, but it is going to be much more difficult and the landscape will be very competitive because there are plenty of people that do have this technical background or a technical skill set to show that are going to be harder for you to display. That's going to make it even more important that your resume is extremely sharp to demonstrate exactly how you're able to utilize these skills and fulfill the needs of the role. When you're ready to prepare your resume to get a data scientist job or a data analyst job, check out the link below where I offer a training that teaches you everything that you need to know to build the perfect data analyst or data scientist resume. Thanks so much for watching. I hope to see you back next time. Please consider subscribing and liking this video if you'd like to see more content just like this.